हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आर टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज MRAPS के टेक्निक। द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टुडेज लेक्चर आर टू एक्सप्लेन द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ MRA मॉड्यूलेशन टेक्निक्स एंड एक्सप्लेन डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ MRAPS के टेक्निक। द MRA मॉड्यूलेशन टेक्निक, द वर्ड बाइनरी रिप्रेजेंट्स टू बिट्स। M represents a digit that corresponds to the number of conditions, levels or combinations possible for a given number of binary variables. In an M array signaling scheme, we can send one of M possible signals such as S1 of T, S2 of T up to Sm of T during each signaling interval of duration T seconds. M is equal to 2 raised to N. That means here N is an interval. So M array signaling scheme, it is used to conserve channel bandwidth, and this is achieved at the cost of increasing transmitted power and error probability. Now we can see here the M array systems, the types of this, like MRAPSK, MRAQAM and MRAPSK. Now in today's lecture, we are going to discuss about MRAPSK technique. Basically, as we have seen the types of MRA techniques over here, that is MRAASK, MRAFSK, MRAQAM technique over here. There are many MRA modulation techniques. If you consider for MRAASK, this is called as MRA amplitude shift keying. The amplitude of the carrier signal takes on M different levels and representation of MRAASK. The MRAFSK, this is called as MRAFSK, this is the frequency of the carrier takes on M different levels. Representation of MRAFSK is SI of T is equal to under root of 2 ES by TS cos of pi by TS NC plus I of T over here, whereas T it is in between 0 to TS and for I it is up to M. Now we can see for MRAPSK system over here. Into this, if you see, that is the there are M number of symbols are represented by sinusoidal signals of duration TS that is equal to NTB, which differ from one another by the phase 2 pi by M radians. Thus, the MRAPSK waveform can be mathematically expressed or represented as V of MRAPSK, it is equal to under root of 2 PS cos of omega C plus phi M, whereas M is 0, 1 and up to M minus 1 over here. So we can see a geometric representation of the same over here in of MRAPSK signals. So here phi M, it represents the symbol phase angle which is given by phi M. It is equal to under in bracket 2M plus 1 pi by M over here. So we can find out this is U1 of T, that is the first carrier, under root of 2 by TS cos omega CT. After this angle, that is pi by M, when your M will be is equal to 0 on that time, what we are getting? Phi of M is nothing but pi by M. For M is equal to 2, we are getting like it is 3 pi by M over here. So if you see the S1 point over here from the carrier, that is from this 0, we are getting the angle 3 pi by M, or from S0, the angle is 2 pi by M over here. So in this way, the MRAPSK waveforms, it corresponds to the above equation and represented by dots. This is a signal space diagram in which the coordinate axes are formed by orthogonal waveforms, that is U1 of T and U2 of T. There are some orthogonal signals used for the signal space representation of a QPSK signal. The distance of each MRAPSK waveform from the origin, here we can find out, it is under root of ES, that is nothing but under root of PS TS. Now, the phase of the carrier signal takes place on the MRA different levels. So, some features of MRAPSK are, the envelope is constant with more phase possibilities. This method was used during early days of space communication. It has better performance than ASK and FSK. Minimum phase estimation error at the receiver. The bandwidth efficiency of MRAPSK decreases and the power efficiency increases with the increasing M. Now for 8 PSK, instead of M array PSK, now what we can consider 8 PSK. If 3 bits are brought together to form a message or symbol, then there will be 2 raised to 3, that is 8 messages. A PSK system that uses 8 different phase shifts to transmit 8 symbols is known as a 8 PSK system. So here we can see the symbols with 3 bit like 000 to 111. These are the combinations of possible symbols. So for the same, the phase shifts are written over here. That is, we need to divide 0 to 360 degree by 8. Because for 8 different symbols, we need 8 different phases. So we can easily find out it will be 0 for the first symbol. Then for the second symbol, the phase will be 45 degree. And up to last symbol, we can find out the phase shift is 350. We can find out the constellation diagram of this also. That is, in this constellation diagram, we can find out this is for angle 0 for 000 symbol. Then this is the angle that is 45 degree for 001 symbol. And similarly, we can find out 315 degree, that is for last symbol, that is 111. Now we can find out the bandwidth of the M array PSK also. Here actually the baud rate is 1/3 of the bit rate of 8 PSK system. So here we can find out the bandwidth is 1 by TS is equal to minus 1 by TS. So it is nothing but 2 by TS, but we know that is TS is equal to N into TB over here. So we can easily find out that is the bandwidth of a PSK system is 2FB by N. We remember and we know that is the bandwidth of BPSK is twice FB. And the above expression, this expression tells us that with increasing number of bits per message, the bandwidth reduces. Now, in M array FSK PSK transmitter, we can find out the bit stream B of T. It is applied to a serial to parallel converter. This block can store the N bits of symbols. These N bits per symbol have been presented serially in time sequence one after the other. The N bits per symbol are first assembled by serial to parallel converter block. Then all these bits are presented at once on the N input lines of the converter. So here we can find out it is given to the digital to analog converter over here. The output of a serial to parallel converter remains unchanged for the duration of NTB of a symbol, which is time required for the converter to assemble a new groups of N bits. After every NTB second, the converter output is updated. The N bit output of the converter is then applied to a D2A converter over here. Depending on the N bit digital input, it produces an analog output voltage, that is VA, which is again then applied to the sinusoidal signal source phase controlled by VA. The N bit digital input can have 2 raised to N, that is M number of possible combinations. Therefore, D2A converter output will have M number of distinct values depending on the symbols. And finally, this analog voltage is applied to a sinusoidal signal generator, which produces a constant amplitude sinusoidal output voltage, the phase phi m of which is determined by the D2A converter output. Thus, at the output of the transmitter here, we get a fixed amplitude sinusoidal waveform, the phase of which has 1-to-1 correspondence to the n bit symbols. The phase will change only once per symbol time, that is TS is equal to NTB. Thus, the M array PSK is generated over here. So, we can see here the serial to parallel converter, the working of that block. Now, if we go for the M array PSK receiver. In this block, we can find out the M array receiver operates on the principle of synchronous demodulation, which we had discussed for the BPSK and QPSK also. The carrier recovery system, this is a carrier recovery system which will require a device which can raise the received signal to mth power. This signal is then applied to a bandpass filter, the center frequency of which has been selected to be M into FC over here. At the filter output, we get the sinusoidal at frequency MFC, that is mth harmonic of the carrier frequency FC. This frequency is then divided by M to obtain the carrier at the FC. The two carriers produced at the filter output are cos omega CT and sin omega CT. These recovered carriers are then applied to two multipliers. We can see here sin omega CT, it is applied to upper multiplier, and cos omega CT, it is applied to lower multiplier over here. Thus, the output of balance modulators are applied to the integrators. So, here we can see this is output of first modulator, it is applied to the integrator over here, similarly for the second modulator. The integration over the in time interval, that is from 0 to 2 years, it is generated by with the help of this integrator. These integrators will work along with the bit synchronization, obviously, which has not been shown over here, but it's there actually. The outputs of the integrators are proportional to the TSPE. Here also we can see that is TSPO respectively, and the outputs or change at the symbol rate. These outputs are then applied to the A to D converter over here, which is the n-bit transmitted signal. This signal is again converted into B of T by using parallel to serial converter. Now the operating system with n is equal to 4 bits and n is equal to 2^4, that is equal to 16, are common. The bandwidth of such a system will be given, that is 2fb divided by n. So it depends, that is, what is the n, integer n. That is, if it is 4 bits, we can easily find out the bandwidth is nothing but fb by 2. Here the carrier recovery section we have seen in the block diagram. It consists of raised input to the mth power devices, bandpass filter and frequency divider. And we have seen that is received signal is applied to raised to the mth power device, filter and frequency divider over here. And the frequency divider divides the incoming carrier frequency by the factor of m. At the output, carriers are generated and provided to the recovery section over here. And for the data recovery section, which consists of multiplexer, integrators and ADC, we have seen that is how they are working and how at the end we are getting the original signal back. So the advantages of MRA PSK system are bandwidth reduces with increase in the number of bits per symbol, as the information is transmitted through signal phase and not through signal amplitude. This system operates very well in this situation where the signal amplitude varies due to the characteristic of transmission medium. If you see the disadvantages of MRA PSK, the probability of error increases with increase in the number of bits n per symbol, as the distance d decreases with increasing n. The transmitter and receiver of the MRA PSK system is very complex. We can again easily find out, that is for MRA systems, the M, that is nothing but equal to 2^n. So it depends on how many number of bits are used over here. So if it is 8 array PSK, the number of bits will be 3. If it is, for example, 16 array PSK system, M is equal to 16, that means N is equal to 4. So we can easily find out the symbol deviation will be 4 TB over here. And so we can find out the bandwidth reduction over here, that is 2fb divided by 4. So it is nothing but fb divided by 2 over here. So if number of bits are increasing, the bandwidth requirement will be decreasing in the case of MRA PSK. We can again compare the MRA PSK with the other MRA FSK, MRA QAM systems also, and we can find out that here, the MRA systems which we have seen, that is the Euclidean distance we can find out over here, which is nothing but 2 into under root of es sine pi by m over here, and the constellation diagrams we have seen over here. So at the conclusion of this, we can find out, we have studied the MRAP-PSK system, we have seen the advantages, disadvantages, transmitter and receiver for the scene. Thank you.